the Lord of sea and sky. I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin. My hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send?
To the 2021 Holy Cross Graduation Liturgy of the Word. My name is Natalie Haliba, and I'm the chaplaincy leader here at Holy Cross. I started working at Holy Cross the same year that our grads were entering grade 9. I am so proud of all of you, and I will miss your presence at our school. What an incredible group of leaders you are. At your grade 9 retreat, you chose your class name, the Class of Motivation. Over the past 4 years, I have witnessed you motivate others through your hard work, creativity, faith, and acts of service. I pray that you will continue to be leaders of motivation for yourself and others in the year to come. Our church and our world needs your faith, hope, joy, and energy. In this liturgy, we come together as a faith community to celebrate and give thanks to God for the gifts and achievements of our graduates. We give thanks for the opportunity to have a Catholic education. We give thanks for the family, friends, and staff who have nurtured and supported our students throughout the years. In this liturgical celebration, we ask for God's blessings upon our graduating class as they embark on the next part of their journey.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter and John were going up to the temple area for the 3 o'clock hour of prayer. A man, crippled from birth, was carried and placed at the gates of the temple called the Beautiful Gate, every day to beg for alms from the people who entered the temple. When he saw Peter and John about to go into the temple, he asked for alms. But Peter looked intently at him, as did John, and said, "Look at us." He paid attention to them, expecting to receive something from them. Peter said, "I have neither silver nor gold, but what I do have, I give to you. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Nazarene, rise and walk." Then Peter took him by the right hand and raised him up. And immediately his feet and ankles grew strong. He leaped up, stood, and walked around, and went into the temple with them, walking and jumping and praising God. When all the people saw the man walking and praising God, they recognized him as the one who used to sit begging at the beautiful gate of the temple. And they were filled with amazement and astonishment at what had happened to them. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The response to this psalm is, "The message goes out through all the earth. The heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament proclaims his handiwork. Day pours out to word to day, and night to night imparts knowledge. Their message goes out through all the earth. Not a word nor a discourse whose voice is not heard. Through all the earth their voice resounds, and to the ends of the world their message. Their message goes through all the earth."
Hi, Father Tom here. In case some of you don't know who I am, I'm your chaplain. I'm very pleased to be your chaplain at HCC. And today we're celebrating your graduation, which is such an important time in your life, and you're going away from the walls of this particular school and our community and reaching out in many different ways. So today I want to share with you, as your chaplain, a scripture passage from the Gospel of Mark. And so let me read it, and then I'll explain why. So this is Jesus heals a man who's paralyzed. And it says, "When Jesus returned to Capernaum after some days, it was reported that he was at home. So many gathered around that there was no longer room for them, not even in front of the door. And he was speaking the word to them. Then some people came, bringing to him a paralyzed man, carried by four of his friends. And when they could not bring him to Jesus because of the crowd, they removed the roof above him, and after having dug through it, they let down the mat on which the paralytic lay. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, 'Son, your sins are forgiven.' Now, some of the scribes were sitting there questioning in their hearts, 'Why does this fellow speak in this way? It is blasphemy. Who can forgive sins but God alone?' At once Jesus perceived in his spirit that they were discussing these questions among themselves, and he said to them, 'Why do you raise these questions in your hearts? Which is easier to say, your sins are forgiven, or to say, stand up and take your mat and walk? But so that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins,' he said to the paralytic, 'I say to you, stand up, take your mat, and go to your home.' And he stood up, and immediately took the mat and went out before all of them, so that they were all amazed and glorified God, saying, 'We have never seen anything like this.'" The reason why I chose this particular gospel for your graduation is because of the importance that the four friends had in this in their friend's life, there, who was paralyzed. It was their faith, their relationship with Jesus, that brought them to bring forward their friend who was in need. And obviously they had a relationship with Jesus. Jesus who is truly God. Jesus who is truly man. Fully human, fully divine. And we know that by the incarnation. They had a relationship with Jesus. At some point in time, these four friends must have had an encounter with Christ. Because they were willing to go to extremes to present their friend who is paralyzed to Jesus. It's almost comical when you start reading this particular scripture because, you know, you can almost picture them standing up on the roof and opening up the roof. Imagine if we did that today. People think we were nuts. But the important aspect is that they brought their friend to Jesus because they encountered Christ themselves. Today, you are graduating from HCC. You are leaving the walls of the school, not only with the knowledge that you've learned academically, but also with the knowledge that Jesus walks with you. You do not leave Jesus behind, but you take him with you. And my prayer and hope for all of you is that you have a personal encounter with Christ, that you know that you can have a personal relationship with Jesus, who loves you, who provides for you, who guides you and nurtures you in so many different ways. But we need to allow that to happen. And I encourage you to turn to Jesus, to Christ, who is our God, and to allow him to use you. Because I know you all have friends, and I know that not all your friends are necessarily in a good place right now. They need you, and you can bring them to Christ. But you yourself have to know Christ before you can bring anybody else. No matter where you are in life, Jesus is with you. Christ is with you. Christ loves you. And I want to say it again, you can have that personal relationship with Christ. If you really want to experience true joy, happiness, faithfulness, success in your life, you're going to find it in Christ, who loves you deeply. Rest assured of my continued prayers for all of you, and congratulations to all of you. God bless.
The response to our prayer is, Lord, hear our prayer. We pray in thanksgiving for the gift of Catholic education and for the many blessings that we have received during our years at Holy Cross. May God bless our dedicated teachers, support staff, and administrators who have become role models for us. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray in deepest gratitude for our parents and family members who have stood by us throughout our high school years. May each of our families strive to become closer through you, Lord Jesus. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for the community of friends that we have made at our school. May we continue to provide strength, love, and hope to one another in the years to come. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray that we may carry all that we have learned in our time at Holy Cross into the world. May we use our gifts in service of others. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for the many students who will grace these halls after us, that our faith, our compassion, and our acts of service will lead a legacy that inspires them in their Catholic leadership. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
We entrust all of our prayers to our loving God, those spoken out loud and those prayers that we hold in our hearts. We join now in praying the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Gracious Father, We have undergone many challenges this year. Our class embarked upon our senior year in a slightly different manner. One, accommodating the complications of the COVID-19 pandemic. Yet you remain by our sides amid uncertainty. If only we were to look. If only we were to continue looking. Fortis in Concordia, together we are stronger, is our school motto. This year, we learned that togetherness extends beyond the physical sense. We have accompanied one another for 4 years, sharing experiences and extraordinary memories. And through it all, we remain united as children of God and as one community. In our togetherness and in you, O Lord, we find strength. We thank you for lending us your might in trying times, your words as comfort, and your presence in isolation. We thank you too for compassionate teachers, school staff, families, and friends. We pray for your blessings as we proceed into this new exciting stage of life. We ask this through your name, Amen. In the name of the Father, Son, the Holy Spirit, Amen.
Congratulations to you, the graduating class of 2021. Throughout your education, you have been on a journey of learning, growing, observing, and loving. It was a journey that began in your home, with your family, and a journey that continues in the next chapter of life. Some of you will go off to post-secondary education, some to the world of work, and some are still discerning. Wherever you are on your journey, we hope you remember that God loves you. St. Paul, in his letter to the Christian community of Rome, reminds us that nothing can separate us from the love of Christ. The faith community in St. Paul's time knew many hardships, and he reminds them that in all of this, through life's ups and downs, through hardships and sickness, nothing can separate us from God's love, who loved us so much that he sent us his Son. It is this love of Christ that we, as a faith community, celebrate each time we gather for the celebration of the Eucharist, each time we pray. It is this love of Christ that you and I, the people of God, are meant to share with others. So I ask you to allow yourselves to be open to the love of God, for nothing can separate us from this love. Be open to growing closer to God and be open to living the gospel. God is calling you to work for a better future. In life, we have some important decisions to make. Who will we become? What will we do? What kind of person do I want to be known as? What career will I pursue? Most of these questions are questions around character. Will I be known as a kind person or not, a generous person or not, a good Samaritan or one who walks past those in need? In Pope Francis's encyclical letter to the Church, he says, each day we have to decide whether to be good Samaritans or indifferent bystanders. And if we extend our gaze to the history of our own lives and that of the entire world, all of us are, or have been, like each of the characters in the parable. All of us have in ourselves something of the wounded man, something of the robber, something of the passers-by, and something of the good Samaritan. Let us choose to be good people, to be the good Samaritan. There are so many ways we can get involved in kind words, in small gestures of love, in becoming involved in working for justice and peace, and in being instruments of peace. dare to be different, dare to be people who promote good, who work for forgiveness and reconciliation, who take care of the earth and those who are in it. Finally, I offer you this blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look kindly upon you and give you his peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Lately I've been reeling, watching the nightly news. Don't seem to find the rhythm, just wanna sing the blues. Feels like a song that never stops. Feels like it's never gonna. Gotta get that fire back in my bones before my heart turns into stone. So when somebody please pass the megaphone, I'll shout it on the count of three.
Joy down in my heart to stay.